Chris Menard here. If you're wondering what in the world happened to your Microsoft Teams, maybe you haven't experienced this yet, but you soon will. Microsoft is combining chats and channels together. The official name for this is the new chat and channels experience in Microsoft Teams. Let me show you how this is going to work. I don't want you to get alarmed. It does look completely different, but it has some great features. Let's dive in right now. So I've already got the new experience. The first thing I want you to notice is over on the app bar or the sidebar over to the far left, Teams is no longer there. Activity, chat, calls, but you do not see Teams. Under chat, what we have done is we've given the ability to combine all your Teams with their channels, and chat is all in one place. For terminology, in the old Teams, when you clicked on chat, you had two groups or sections. You had your pinned chats at the top, and you could have 15 pinned chats, and you could move those around. And then down below there, you had recent. You could not move your recent, but your Teams meetings were there. Those two terms are no longer used for chat. Now, when I click on chat, just to show you this, you will have a section called favorites. So favorites is a section, and Teams decided who to put in my favorites automatically, and it rolled out to me on November 14th. I actually had a couple of channels in here. So if you're wondering, these are chats right here. If I want to add the budget channel to my favorites, I open up Teams and channels. All my teams are still listed here, and then the channels for each team. I'm going to come to the three dots by budget, and notice we have a show in, and it says favorites, and I'm going to click it. Budget channel is now part of my favorites, and I can move this around and put it wherever I want to, so I just dragged it up to the top. I'm going to click it and pull it down a couple more spots, so you can mix your chats and channels. I mentioned that favorites was a section. This is where I'm loving this new layout, because what happens to me in real life, and I've been using Teams since 2017, and I do a lot of chats, and I'm also involved in a lot of teams and channels. I'm in a group chat, but that group chat, we also have a channel, so I got to leave the group chat, go select Teams in the past, go find the channel, and then go look at the conversation. A lot of clicking for a group chat and a channel that were basically related. So what I can do now, let's say I have a customer or a client or a project. All the way up at the very top right here, it says new items. So I'm about to make a new section. That is brand new that it says new section. But look, there's a new message. There's a new channel. You can still make channels and teams the old way. Join team, create a new team, but here's new section. Let's go back to a client. I'm just going to pick on a client. This client is called XYZ. This could again be a project. It could be your department, whatever. I'm going to click on create. So I created a new section for XYZ. I'm going to put Christian in here. I could come here and click and put move to, and notice that it found the XYZ immediately, or you can just drag and drop people into your sections. The same way I dragged and dropped the Christian chat into XYZ section. Let's open up this department. I've got benefits. I'm going to click, drag, and drop there also. So notice it still stays, benefits still stays actually inside of this team, which it should, but this is a shortcut to it. You don't want it here. You come in here and click and you remove from the section if you don't want it in that section. But I'm loving this section feature. So if I'm chatting with Christian, I click on Christian, and Christian are also involved in the benefits channel. I click on benefits and I am in that channel right now. Great feature. One feature that I have found that's missing, and let's just, before I discuss the missing feature, this came out on November 14th to people that have a Teams public preview. I'm just going to show you this up in the top right, settings and more, then click settings. And then in the bottom left, select about teams. And you'll see that I'm under early access public preview is checked for me. Most likely if you work for a company, you're probably not under public preview. You could be though. Back to chat. So Microsoft was initially going to release this to general availability, the GA, in November. I believe that has been pushed to January. So you are going to get this at some point, and that is why I'm making this video now for you. Feature that is missing, and I have noticed this, before I got this new chat and channels experience, I could delete an entire chat. Now, when you do that, it only deletes it for you, not for the other person. But I notice if I come here and click, I can hide this chat, I can mute this chat, nothing new there, but I don't see the ability yet to delete the entire chat, and we have that in the previous layout of Teams. Just letting you know, but I've got a feeling that's going to be coming. Also believe that Microsoft will tweak this a little bit. Up at the very, very top, let me go ahead and discuss these items. I have Discover. Discover only happens with your channels. Discover is not for chat. But since we've combined them, I have Discover here. If I don't want to see Discover, I could easily hide it. I also have Copilot. You'll only see Copilot if you have an M365 Copilot license. So if you don't, and that's an additional fee, if you don't have Copilot, you're not going to see Copilot. And then I have an at mentions. There's my at mentions right there. Here's my Copilot. If you do have Copilot, just to show you this. And then here's my Discover. I don't have any recent channel updates, so it didn't find anything. If you click right here, here are your filters. Before I discuss filters, I'm going to back here. If you come over to more list options up at the top and click on it, this is where you can hide your filters. You can hide your Discover. I could hide Copilot if I want to. I don't want to, but I'm going to pull those back. So you can, if you don't like the top being so busy, you can remove some of these items. Back over here, I showed you how to turn the filters on and off, but I like this feature. So let's discuss this. First of all, there's an arrow to see more or fewer. It is up to you. I'm just going to show them all. If you want to see only your unread items, you click unread. Now, I don't have any, but this would be unread chats. And it would be unread conversation messages in my channels. It would be both. If you want to filter it from unread and say, I just want to see unread chats, you're going to select unread and you're going to select chats. I'm going to turn the chats off and I'm back, and I would be back looking at all unread items. If you want to see your unread channel notifications or messages, you would click on channels right here. Turn that off. If you only want to see your meeting chats, you select meetings. It says see, click it. There are just nothing but meetings for me right there. I'm going to turn that off. If you want to see items that you have muted, you click on muted. And these are meetings that I have muted because afterwards I didn't want any more. I didn't care about the conversation inside that chat. So anyway, there are your filters right up here. Again, collapse and expand them. One more time, if you don't want to see them, just turn them off, but I'm going to leave them running. Mark all as read. That feature is still available up there. Here's a collapse all sections. This is a cool one. Watch this. So I've got a lot of stuff expanded. I'm just going to say collapse all sections. They all got collapsed. And again, I can sit here and expand my teams. One thing you can't do, and I want to be clear about this, because I know someone's going to ask me about this. I'm sitting here with my favorite section. I'm sitting here with my XYZ section. I have a team called Department Accounting. You can't put a team in a section. Just letting you know that. You put channels in the sections, not teams. If you click here, by the way, just so you know this, good news. You still got all your team information right here. Manage the team, add a channel, add members. All this information is still here, including archiving a team. I've got a video on archiving teams also. Really important also. If you're saying, Chris, those sections were pretty cool, but I'm not sold. I want to go back to the old method. The answer is right now you can. Let me show you how to do that. I can click here and it is custom view. This is exactly the same as clicking the three dots in the right for settings and more. Settings, and we're going to end up at the same spot, which is chats and channels. Notice it's under settings. Here you go. I'm going to actually swap it right now. I've got combined. I'm going to go back to separate. Now I've got my chats again over here to the left, and I've got my teams listed below it. Notice teams, app mention and discover, chat. That is where I'm going to find my co-pilot and my app mentions. I'm going to swap back. What I want to be clear about is I have heard that Microsoft is going to let you change this from combined to separate, but at some point this is going to go away and it's not going to be like classic Teams and new Teams where they gave you months. This is going to happen pretty quick. So I guess I'm encouraging you, if possible, just to stay in this combined. I went back to combined, and Teams is no longer listed over on the sidebar. I believe I've covered everything. I'm loving this right now. If you have any questions, please put them down below. I will be updating my Microsoft Teams online training class because a lot of the material I've got out there for chats and channels is going to change. I have other online training available in Excel, Copilot, and OneNote. I appreciate your time. Have a great day.